Hi students, this is Jayapai speaking on the topic that is anti-knocking agents. So in the previous class, we did study something about knocking in great detail. So in this class, let us study something about anti-knocking agents. Now as the name indicates, anti-knocking agents means these are the compounds which are added to motor fuels or aviation fuels. Gasoline means nothing but petrol here. Motor or aviation gasoline for containing or controlling knocking in IC engines. So compounds that are added to motor or aviation gasoline in order to reduce knocking or in order to control knocking in IC engines are called anti-knocking agents. Examples for anti-knocking agents are given here. First one, it is tetraethyl lead. Tetraethyl lead, this is the formula of tetraethyl lead, C2H5 4 times Pb. Similarly, we have a tetramethyl lead, that is CH3 4 times Pb. And then we have mixed ethyl methyl lead. So first one is tetraethyl lead, that is TEL, tetraethyl lead. And second one, tetramethyl lead, that is called TML. And then we can have mixture of these two, that is mixed ethyl methyl lead. Many different types of anti-knocking agents are available in the market. Among the many anti-knocks available, tetraethyl lead is the most widely used. It is largely being used as an anti-knocking agent because of two reasons. One is it is cheaper. Tetraethyl lead is cheaper compared to other anti-knocks available commercially. And second one, it is more effective in increasing the octane rating of fuels, or it is more effective in reducing knocking. In that way also we can tell. So among the many anti-knocks commercially available, tetraethyl lead is widely used for two reasons. One is it is cheaper compared to other anti-knocking agents, and it is more effective in reducing knocking, or it is more effective in increasing the octane rating of fuels. Higher the octane rating, better the fuel, and lower the knocking. The normal dosage of tetraethyl lead, it is 4 cm cube per gallon of petrol. The normal dosage of tetraethyl lead is 4 cm cube per gallon of petrol. That means 1 gallon petrol, we are adding just 4 cm cube. 1 gallon is nothing but that is 4.365 liter. About 4.5 liters of petrol, we are adding just 4 cm cube of petrol. 4 cm cube tetraethyl lead. Now tetraethyl lead is normally used along with the ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride. Whenever we are using tetraethyl lead, it is always recommended to use along with the either ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride. This is always advisable to use tetraethyl lead with the ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride whenever it is used as an anti-knocking agent. That is because you may ask now, what is the reason why we have to add ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride? During the combustion of gasoline, when combustion of gasoline takes place or combustion of petrol occurs in the engine, tetraethyl lead undergoes decomposition to form lead and lead oxide. Tetraethyl lead forms, I mean it undergoes decomposition to form lead and lead oxide. These species, they will be, highly reactive. These species are highly reactive and they actually curtail the propagation of explosive chain reaction taking place in the engine. That is explosive combustion, what is taking place during when the fuel air mixture is compressed beyond the critical compression ratio, what we have studied, that explosive combustion takes place, those series of reactions will be curtailed, that is by the presence of lead and lead oxide. They act as free radical chain inhibitors. Inhibitors means they inhibit the explosive chain reaction. They will not make explosive chain reaction possible in the engine, thereby minimizing knocking. Hence, knocking will be greatly reduced. So, what I told you that tetraethyl lead is widely used as an anti-knocking agent for two reasons: that it is comparatively cheaper and it is more effective in increasing the octane number of the fuel, or it is more effective in reducing knocking in a engine. Octane rating and knocking, they are inversely proportional. Higher the octane number, lower the knocking. How much tetraethyl lead is generally recommended? Tetraethyl lead, it is about 4 centimeter cube per gallon of petrol. 1 gallon means it is 4.365 liter. So tetraethyl lead, it is normally used along with ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride. The reasons are, when gasoline undergoes combustion in IC engines, tetraethyl lead undergoes combustion forming lead and lead oxide. These species will reduce explosive chain reaction. It will actually curtail the explosive chain reaction taking place during under the conditions where fuel and air mixture is compressed beyond the critical compression ratio. In fact, they act as free radical chain inhibitors, thereby minimizing knocking. In other words, you can say lead and lead oxide will minimize knocking. But if tetraethyl lead is used alone, the species may get deposited on engine parts and cause mechanical damage. If you are not using ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride along with tetraethyl lead, then the species, that is lead and lead oxide, they will get deposited on engine parts, and when they get deposited on engine parts, the mechanical damage will take place. In order to avoid mechanical damage, tetraethyl lead is always used along with the ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride. Now what happens during that? Now let us see what are the ill effects of tetraethyl lead. Lead and lead oxide, they get deposited on the engine parts and they will cause mechanical damage. That is one disadvantage. Another thing, lead halides escape into atmosphere and pollute air. Now in the previous slide, I told you that if tetraethyl lead is alone used, this lead and lead oxide will get deposited on engine parts. But if you are using it with the ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride, then lead and lead dioxide will convert ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride into lead chloride or lead bromide. This lead chloride and lead bromide, they are highly volatile compared to lead and lead oxide. So they escape into air and they will start, they cause environmental pollution. Lead halides, that is lead chlorides or lead bromides, they escape into atmosphere and pollute air. And it does not allow the attachment of catalytic converter to the exhaust system. Nowadays, all the vehicles, they are fitted with the catalytic converters near the exhaust system. Catalytic converter is the one, it is a device which converts harmful gases into less harmful gases. For example, carbon monoxide in the exhaust, if it passes through the catalytic converter, that gets converted into carbon dioxide. If oxides of nitrogen are there in the catalytic converter, in the exhaust system, then catalytic converter will convert oxides of nitrogen into nitrogen and oxygen. So, catalytic converter is very useful in a vehicle exhaust because it converts harmful gases into less harmful gases. Because we have large number of disadvantages, that is disadvantages while using tetraethyl lead, and having come to know the its ill effects, now we cannot entertain the use of tetraethyl lead in petrol. Therefore, nowadays tetraethyl lead is not available anywhere. Across the world, tetraethyl lead is totally banned. And we are getting now only unleaded petrol. Petrol which is free from lead is called unleaded petrol. Whatever petrol you are getting, which is absolutely free from lead, and that is called unleaded petrol. Though tetraethyl lead increases the octane rating of the gasoline, when you add tetraethyl lead, it is found that octane number of petrol increases by 10 to 15 points. As a result, knocking reduces to a greater extent. Even then, it has some disadvantages. Disadvantages like during the burning of the fuel, if tetraethyl lead is there in fuel, they will get converted into lead and lead oxide, and they get deposited on the engine parts, causing mechanical damage. That is one of the big disadvantage. Another minus for us, because we are using tetraethyl lead along with the ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride, this lead and lead oxide will convert ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride into lead halides, that is lead chloride or lead bromide. In other words, I can say like this, ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride added will convert lead and lead oxide into respective halides, that is lead halides, that is lead bromide or lead chloride. These halides being less volatile compared to lead and lead oxide, they escape into atmosphere and pollute air. And moreover, lead is present in the exhaust means it will damage the catalytic converter. And catalytic converter in the exhaust system, it is fitted in order to convert harmful gases into less harmful gases. And nowadays, for all these reasons, we are using unleaded petrol. It is the one which is absolutely free from lead. When you add tetraethyl lead, it increases the octane rating of petrol by 10 to 15 points. But it has many limitations or disadvantages. Of late, therefore, it has become mandatory, or it has it has been made mandatory to use unleaded petroleum for automobiles. Now the compelling reasons are why we have to use unleaded petrol only. One thing is, lead is highly toxic. It is a heavy metal, it is highly toxic. The recognition of health hazard associated with its release into the atmosphere from the automobile exhaust, it has led to banning of its use in gasoline. When lead enters our atmosphere, there is a chance that it may enter our body, and if it enters our body, it might get accumulated even in blood or in the brain. If it gets accumulated in the brain, it is observed that in such persons the IQ level greatly reduces, especially among children. The IQ of the child is found to decrease by 6 to 10 points. Those students who are lead poisoned, when they were diagnosed for lead poisoning, and later when they were kept in observation for some time, they were found not to do well in academics, and they used to suffer from various types of problems, especially mental retardness. So lead, because of this reason, nowadays lead is totally banned. Kids or children who are lead poisoned, they are found to perform badly in academics, because that will have calamitous effect on their academic performance. However, those students who are not doing well in academics, that doesn't mean that they are lead poisoned. Another factor for reducing its use in petrol is the requirement of vehicles to be fitted with the catalytic converters, which control the pollutants. Only unleaded petrol can be used in vehicles fitted with catalytic converters, because lead inactivates the catalyst used in the converters. So I have already told you that catalytic converters are fitted to the exhaust of the vehicle to control pollutants. They actually convert harmful gases into less harmful gases. Only unleaded petrol can be used in vehicles fitted with catalytic converters, because lead is found to deactivate the catalysts used in converters. Generally, the catalyst used are platinum, palladium, and rhodium. The catalyst used in catalytic converters, they are, one is platinum, another one palladium, and one more is rhodium. All these catalysts are costlier, but they are very effective in controlling the pollutants. They will control pollutants, like they will convert carbon monoxide, a deadly poison, into carbon dioxide. They convert oxides of nitrogen into nitrogen and oxygen. They convert hydrocarbons unburnt in the IC engine into carbon dioxide and steam. But if you are using tetraethyl lead in petrol, that lead will deactivate all these catalysts, and hence the catalytic converter will lose its efficiency to control pollutants. For the same reason, unleaded petrol rating can be enhanced by the addition of certain other compounds in place of tetraethyl lead. These are methyl tertiary butyl ether, famously known as MTBE, and ethyl tertiary butyl ether, ETBE, and methanol and ethanol. These are the compounds nowadays added to petrol in order to increase its octane number and also to reduce knocking in engines. Moreover, these are absolutely lead free. So in our today's discussion, what and all we have studied, let us just summarize. The first thing we have studied, that is about anti-knocking agents. definition of anti-knocking agents you are supposed to be knowing. Then some examples. Among the many anti-knocking agents used, which one is widely being used and what is the reason? And then why ethylene dibromide and ethylene dichloride, ethylene dibromide or ethylene dichloride used along with the, I mean, tetraethyl lead? And what are the advantage, I mean, what are the disadvantages of using a tetraethyl lead? And why unleaded petrol has been made mandatory across the world? And what is the role of catalytic converters? And what are the catalysts used in converters? And what if leaded petrol is used when catalytic converter is fitted in, when catalytic converter is a part of the exhaust system? And how we can control knocking in IC engines without tetraethyl lead? And what are the various compounds we are using in order to control or contain knocking in IC engines, and which are absolutely lead free? So these are some of the points you are supposed to be knowing. Hope this lecture has given some insight on these concepts. These are not very important as far as examination point is concerned, but it is somewhat general knowledge, and you need to be knowing, not because it is there in the syllabus, but because additional knowledge, and also to enrich your knowledge, you are supposed to be, supposed to have this extra information. You might get one question here: what is unleaded petrol and what are the compounds used in petrol nowadays, in order to reduce knocking, which are absolutely lead free. Only this much I wanted to share as far as anti-knocking agents are concerned. In case if you have any doubts and if you still want to enrich your knowledge, anytime you can call your teachers and find out answers for your problems. This is actually, Google, and you can find out more information by yourself. It is quite interesting. But as far as your syllabus is concerned, this much is more than sufficient. Thank you.